Hello, my beautiful soul sister. All right, so we are going to be doing the extended Celtic wing with female-male energies on either side. So it's going to be a pretty big reading, 70 cards. But I am also going to pull 7 cards for the energy regarding the next 7 days, which would include the new moon. Okay? So what is the date today? It's Saturday, February the 25th. Okay, so I'm just going to give these a quick shuffle as well. So I'm going to be doing 1 card from the John Holland Psychic Tarot, and then I'm going to be pulling 2 cards for each position. So the main spread is going to be genderless, and the 2 cards will represent the male and female energies. Okay, I think that's good enough. All right, so, and then I'll pull 2 cards from Call It Baron Reed, and I'm using the Osho deck for the week spread. So, for present position, again, this is going to be a genderless, heartbreak and loss. So the 3 of swords. So this is going to be a shared energy, all right? So I'm going to pull 2 cards. The first one is going to be for the masculine. The Wheel of Fortune. And the Temperance card. So the heartbreak and loss, this talks about coming out of a period where you've experienced some loss, and it's time to heal your heart. So the masculine is bringing in the Wheel of Fortune, but so this means that good luck is now on your side. Lady Luck is pointing right at you. So this represents a period of change. Then we have you with the Temperance card, and this is that badass union card, integration. So it's the union of dualities, the coming together, yin and yang. It's that ultimate spiritual union card. So it seems to me like, you know, you're both experiencing sadness. Now, if you recall the reading I just did, you guys both got that sad embrace in the middle of your reading. So this would represent the same kind of energy. You're both experiencing this sadness and loss and heartbreak. But Spirit is telling you that, you know, union is coming, okay? That the tide is turning in your direction. Okay, so the foundation energy. Throat chakra, again, communication. So this entire spread is going to be based on communication. So the masculine is bringing in the Death card. And the Page of Wands. So major transformation, metamorphosis. Foundation. He's begun this transformation. He has already gone through this. All right. So it's a foundation. So you are bringing in the Page of Wands, which tells me that you're excited to move forward with something. And there's a communication that needs to occur or has occurred. I'll know more about what's going on as we go through the reading here. Okay, so for recent past position, temptation, the Devil card. So this talks about chains, being bonded to something, a codependent relationship, addictions. So the masculine has brought in the Queen of Cups. Nice. 11-11 card. So this confirms once again that this is 11-11 connection. And he's bringing in the Queen of Cups, the Queen of Love. So it's as if he's chained to something, but his heart is with the Queen of Cups. And then you are bringing in this 11-11 connection, which cannot occur because there's something that is stopping you from doing that. Okay, so for the outcome you desire, Four of Swords. This is a recurrent theme. So it's all about rest, rejuvenation, pause. It comes after a period of mental stress. So the masculine is bringing the Nine of Pentacles, and the Divine Feminine is bringing in the Divine Feminine. So you wish to step into your power by retreating and rejuvenating yourself, whereas he is bringing in the Nine of Pentacles, and this came in your reading, and this represents ripeness. The fruit is ready to drop from the tree. Okay, crossroads position. Trapped in fear, not surprised. Eight of Swords. That self-imposed prison. Can't escape the thoughts of your mind. Three of Pentacles for the masculine. And, oh, nice. The King of Cups is always shows up in the reading. So here we got that twin flame connection. So you are bringing in the King of Love. You want to be with the King of Love, but you can't because something is stopping you, preventing you from doing that. So he's bringing in the Three of Pentacles, which represents that beginning in the 3D world. So laying a foundation, being rewarded and acknowledged for it. So it's almost like he's saying, okay, you know, we both feel trapped, like we can't move forward. But I'm working towards the future. Yeah, okay. So let's carry on. So what you both are resisting, the Four of Pentacles, firm foundation. So this represents, it could mean somebody's closed off, holding on too tight, not willing to open, but it also talks about laying that foundation in the 3D world. Okay, so for the masculine energy, Page of Cups, and you are bringing in the King of Pentacles. So this is all about abundance, being at that point in your life where you realize that money isn't important, and what's important is the people that are around you. This could also represent the 3D manifestation of the King in the 3D world. He's bringing in this message of love. He wants to communicate his love for you and possibly his transformation. But there's that sense of resisting. Okay, so the internal environment, deception and envy, Seven of Swords. So this is a feeling, it's the internal environment that you both share, so there's a sense that you both feel like you're being deceived, perhaps. Let's see what the cards show. So the masculine, Nine of Pentacles, feminine, The Tower card. All right, Tower card. So that would be his energy, right? So there's that sense of waiting again, right? Laying that foundation, working towards something in the future, and waiting for that payoff, waiting for the ships to come in. So it's almost like you know, that long wait is causing this feeling of being deceived, and he's not sure how to handle the situation, how to approach you with it. You're bringing in the Tower, so this could represent your energy. Or no, wait, he's the Tower, sorry. So this could represent his energy, in that you feel that he's deceiving you. But if it represents an energy for the card Tower, it would represent that you need to let go of an attachment, or something is going to happen suddenly, or you want something to happen suddenly that'll bring in this major change, new life. Okay, so for the final outcome, we got disruption, the Tower again as an outcome. So this could be his energy coming in. For the masculine, the Knight of Swords. Feminine, the Page of Swords. So, Gemini and Air and him, you know, the Tower card plus the, you know, the air energy here. So it looks to me like you want communication, truthful, honest communication, to be open, and he's coming in one better than that. He's coming in as the Knight, ready to spill his guts. And it will create this sudden change in the future. Okay, so for the external environment, new beginnings, new start. So he is bringing the Eight of Wands, and you are bringing in the Four of Cups. So you both want this new beginning. You're both, you know, taking that step towards the future. He is bringing in this directed energy towards his goal. He's going forward with it. But this could also represent communication. So because it's an external energy, it would represent your external energy. So it's almost like, you know, there's a sense that he wants to communicate with you, that energy surrounding you. But you're bringing in the Four of Cups. You're bringing in this longing, this want to begin this new future. So he can sense that, which is coming in his internal environment. And for the summary outcome, nice, heart chakra, awesome. So he's bringing in the Five of Pentacles, and you are bringing in the Knight of Pentacles, awesome. So he feels left out. There's a sense that he wants to communicate, or he knows where his heart is and he feels left out. You, on the other hand, are bringing in this love, heart-centered energy, and it is a solid energy. It's a forward movement towards that goal, and it's a very successful outcome. Okay, so for the final outcome, sacrifice, hangman. So this would be your card. So this is a brand new perspective. Change in lifestyle, surrender, let go. So he's bringing in the Queen of Swords, and you are bringing in nice, the Ace of Pentacles. So you are standing here with this offer, and he's bringing in this communication, or this could be his energy as well, the air. But it's almost like that final decision to move forward. Okay, so now I'm going to pull the side energies. I'll start with yours. So this is going to be your external environment, which could represent his. Moving on, the Six of Swords. So he's moving from the dark to the light. He's finally ready to put the past behind him. Okay, so I'm going to pull three cards for that. Eight of Swords, mental prison. The Moon, not seeing your way clearly, but also moving from the darkness to the light. And then we have the Eight of Pentacles. So that's working hard towards something in the 3D world. And, you know, having that final harvest. So he is working very hard on building that foundation and materializing that life in the 3D world, but he's also moving from the dark to the light. Okay, so his external environment, which would represent you. Nice, Hermit. Oh, sorry, this was the Hangman. My apologies. This is the Hangman up here. So, yeah, that's different perspective. That's, you know, a change in lifestyle. It's surrender, let go. Whereas the Hermit down here, this is his external environment. So you're coming in as in his external environment. So this is solitude. It's peace, stillness of the mind, wise. Okay, so for his card, strength. And you are bringing in the Six of Wands, success. So, you know, if this represents that energy of solitude, then he is becoming strong as a result of it. He's really connecting to that nurturing, loving energy. And while you are feeling empowered, successful, spirit has recognized you, or rewarding you for all the hard work that you've put in. So for your internal environment, Seven of Pentacles, waiting, patience and planning. You seem to get this. So yeah, that's waiting for the ships to come in. So I'm going to pull, oops, you know what? I made a boo-boo here. So I'm just going to put this card down for a moment before I carry on. This is actually his three cards, right? So he got the Hermit card, the Strength card, Success card, and I'm going to pull one more. Nice! The Ace of Cups, brand new beginning in love. Finally ready to accept love into your heart. So this is his external environment. That is beautiful energy that is surrounding him. That's you, strength, love, compassion, triumph and victory in this new love. Okay, so back to your card here. So I'm pulling three. The Queen of Pentacles. The Two of Pentacles. And the Sun card. Awesome. So it looks to me, now where is that King of Pentacles down here? Okay, so this would be, the court card that goes with this King of Pentacles. So internally, you feel successful. You've worked very hard to build up this wealth for yourself, and you're enjoying the finer things in life. It's almost like you've shifted your thought process here from the other day. You're no longer concentrated on what's out there, but you're now more concentrated on yourself and looking after yourself in the 3D world. So you're finding balance now. You're becoming more flexible while you're waiting for this beautiful, you know, happy ending to come your way. That is beautiful. I love seeing this. Okay, so for his internal environment, nice! Two of Cups! Awesome! So I'm going to pull three cards for him. Nice! Reunion! Three of Cups! Nice! Ten of Cups! Awesome! Awesome! The Two of Wands! Nice! Wow! This is awesome. So he knows his spiritual union. He feels love overflowing. He wants to reunite. Three Cups is all about feeling true love and how it excites you. Then we got the Ten of Cups, that perfect ending, emotional bliss. And then the Two of Wands, it's all about waiting for that return to come. But it's also about expanding your mind. So it's almost like this door is open to this house. Isn't that neat? Oh my God, that is awesome. So your hopes and fear, sacral chakra, again, emotions. Three cards, please. Nice. The Ace of Wands, the go light. Green light to go forward, that brand new beginning in life. You hope for this. You hope for emotional satisfaction and the green light. Okay, nice. The Ten of Pentacles. Oh my God. That's that, you know, that ultimate resting place. It's the point where you've worked enough, you can retire and enjoy your family around you. That's two. That's an ace and a ten. That's an 11, and then two up here. Okay, and then Judgment. Awesome. Karma coming back to you. It's a completion of a major cycle, and that beginning, it's that rebirth. Wow, these cards are incredible. Okay, so his hopes and fears, destiny. So it's all about karma coming back to you. He got this in his present position. Okay, so Page of Pentacles, Seven of Swords, and Chariot. So he hopes to pursue his destiny. He wants to step into his final destination. And he's working towards that with the Page of Pentacles. He started planning and he's putting that plan into motion. Then there's that sense that, you know, the Seven of Swords, which you both got in your internal environment. So he's hoping to move beyond that feeling of deception. And then you got the Chariot, that's that movement forward, going forward, going after your goal. So yeah, there's that sense that he wants to move forward and he's planning on doing that. And the Chariot is success, triumph, victory. So you know, good luck is on his side, good fortune, success, victory, all the good things. Okay, final outcome, Wisdom, the Hierophant, the High Priest, spiritual wisdom. Two of Swords, decision needs to be made. Seven of Cups, not knowing or seeing your way clearly. And the Fool card, awesome. So what I'm seeing here is that a decision will be made that will give you some clarity. You feel confused. Look at all the bright colors here, which will result in that brand new beginning. moving forward, that new start. Here we go, the external environment. You got the Fool card up here. So that's the ignition, that's the go. That's movement towards the sun, out of the darkness. Happiness, childlike innocence, freedom. Okay, so for his final outcome, nice, divine masculine. So there's a sense that he wants, you know, that you're stepping into your divinity in the future, and so will he. So we got the King of Wands, the Magician, and the Ten of Swords. So these two cards together are very similar in that the divine, or see, the Emperor is the authoritarian type person. He plans for the future and he carries those plans out. Whereas the King of Wands is a fire energy and it's the leader. It's the entrepreneur, owning your own business. So there's almost a sense that he's going to step into this ultimate power, become the leader, and manifest this new beginning into the material world. He is the one that will be doing this. This new beginning, he's the master manifester as well. These are three very powerful cards to have. Okay, and then he got the Ten of Swords, so he's snipping something away. He's putting an end to something, and he's stepping into his power, and he's going forward with what he wants. It's a directed goal. Very similar energies that we got in that last reading. Okay, so I'm going to look at the bottom of the deck. Victoring success. Yeah! Woohoo! Yeah! So that's the same card that he got in his external environment. So yeah, that's triumph, success. That's just, you know, everything that you wanted, you will get. It's major reward. Okay, so I'm going to pull two cards for that. So the masculine, nice, the Hierophant, and then the feminine, nice. Oh my God, that's awesome. So overall, there's success in terms of his spirituality, in terms of his awakening, being connected to his crown chakra. He is really stepping into his divinity. That you got the Hierophant twice. You got it as an outcome. And then we got the Knight of Wands. That's going forward towards your goal. It's directed energy. So you got that in the reading as well. So, wow. There's definite forward movement and awakening. Success. Victory. Awesome. Okay, so now I am going to pull seven cards. Woo. So this will represent the next 7 days, not including today. Okay, so tomorrow is Sunday the 26th. So this card will represent tomorrow. What is your message for tomorrow, Sunday, February 26th, yeah. Two possibilities, two wands, expansion. So I will read each one of these cards for you, okay? So you can see what to expect for the next week regarding those days. All right, so that is Sunday. Monday, conditioning, the Devil card. Releasing some bonds or chains. Okay, Tuesday, The Three of Pentacles, guidance. Wednesday. Nice, Eight of Wands. This could be communication coming in. Thursday. The Page of Pentacles, again. So it's moving forward with an idea, moving, you know, into the 3D world. I will be reading these to you. So Friday, nice. The Knight of Cups, message of love, an invitation, an expression of love. Okay, wait, sorry. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Seven of Wands, stress. Okay, so now I'm going to pull message from the universe. Starting with you first. Magical map shifter. And masculine. Nice, ride the wave. Awesome. Oh my God, this is such a good reading. I'm so happy for you, honey. I'm so stoked. Okay, so I'll have a look at the cards. I'm going to run through the reading one more time, and then we'll read those cards for you. All right, cheers. I love you, girlfriend. Okay, here is your reading. So, yeah, I've had a good long look at this. So what I'm seeing here is a major transformation is taking place on, and it's coming from the male aspect. He's letting go of old beliefs, old attachments, and he's moving forward. And what I'm getting is that he is focused mainly on material manifestation. But there is a sense that he's still trapped. But you, however, are providing this excitement, this balance, love, and that is helping to draw him out of this darkness or this transformation. It seems to me like there's going to be some good news coming towards you. And it is going to cause a sudden change, like the tower. And it has to do with communication, which will ignite this new beginning. And as a result, we're going to have this heart chakra explode and victory, payoff, triumph. So on your side, we have the sense of your energy is helping him become drawn out of the darkness. You're providing this stable, grounded energy now. You are the sun, and he's moving from the moon, darkness, to the sun, to the light. I'm no longer seeing this Seven of Pentacles as waiting. I'm actually now seeing it as harvest is just around the corner. Now you're hoping for this illumination, which will come in the form of that new beginning. And ultimately, your emotional chakra will explode as a result of that spark, that new beginning, which was planted here in the past. And you are fueling that fire towards that happy ending, that rebirth. Okay, so over on his side, you are again providing that safe sanctuary, this 5D sanctuary. You are, you're coming in as this, almost this detached hermit state, but you are providing love and comfort and this feeling of success and abundance of love. And that is making his heart chakra open. It's causing him to think about the future in terms of the reunion, this happy ending, and, you know, walking out that door towards his goal. Then we have, he hopes for this ultimate change that he's been working towards, so that he can walk away from negativity on a surfboard, which will ultimately result in him stepping into his power, into his divinity, and manifest the future that he's always wanted. But it requires him to go through the dark night of the soul and release some things that he's bringing into the reading. All right, so for the present position, we have the Three of Swords. As I said before, there's that sense of loss, heartache, that is a shared energy between the two of you. Okay, but he is bringing in change. He's working on something in the background that will help alleviate or move you guys through this heartbreak. It will allow healing to take place. You're bringing in that balance, that integration, kindness, love, compassion. It's there's a sense of holding an energy so that this change can take place. It's patience. You're holding that patient energy, which will help the both of you heal your heart. So you're kind of bringing in the same type of energy here. So as a foundation of the reading, we have communication, the throat chakra. So a conversation took place in the past, recent past, or, you know, it doesn't have to be recent past because this is the recent past energy up here, but this is the foundation. So it's something that happened in the past and it's being brought in as this heavy energy, okay, which ignited this entire reading. So you brought in the Page of Wands. So that is that seed that is planted, that thought, that idea. And it is the ground work in which this idea is going to be manifested in the future. So it could also represent this exciting conversation that took place. It was good news. It was the ignition. You provided the fuel for this idea to move forward. Okay, so as a result of this conversation, this is his energy, the Death card. It ignited a transformation in him. It caused him to look at his life from a different perspective, to actually see, you know, where he needed to make some changes in order to be reborn into a new life, into a new beginning. So he started to, you know, go through that transformation. So this is the foundation energy, and his outcome will be to finally be released from this Death card, from this transformation. It's over, it's done. Okay, so in your recent past, this transformation is linked to the Temptation card, the codependency, this thing that is keeping you from moving forward. So whether it is, you know, it talks about placing too much value on the material world. And so releasing certain attachments. So the energy that you're bringing is this 1111 connection. It's like, bam, it's there. It's undeniable, right? So it's like a slap in the face, which is causing this confusion, this awakening from attachments, from conditioning. So this card shows up in your week reading on Monday. So it's energy that was brought in from the past, but it seems to me like you are going to be confronted with this energy on Monday. Okay, so temptation. So he is bringing in the Queen of Cups, loving, beautiful energy. It makes him want to cut that chain, cut the link, and follow his heart. So the Queen of Cups draws men into the depths of the unconscious. Things that, you know, that are swimming around in the back of the mind but aren't actually being addressed. So you are bringing all those things that, you know, aren't conscious to consciousness. And it has to do with love, emotions. So you are drawing him towards you with your mystery and your beauty and love. So, you know, this temptation here, this death card, he wants to go through a transformation which involves breaking that chain so that he can free himself to move forward towards the love of his life, which is that 1111 connection. Okay, so as an outcome that you both desire, he desires this material harvest, this, you know, the sense of being able to enjoy life. There's a sense that he's bringing that ripeness, you know, as an outcome due to retreating and healing the heart. And you're providing that energy, that love by which this healing can take place. So the Empress or Divine Feminine, she is someone who manifests things into reality and gives birth to it. She brings completions to the project or what have you. So there's a sense that there's two harvest cards. There's two cards that show abundance, which is what you desire, right, after this period of rejuvenation. So his desire is to have that restful, independent, ultimate vacation, if you will, that abundance, that harvest, that completion, ripeness. And while you are hoping to step into your divinity and hold that loving energy, which you will be doing. Okay, so crossroads position, we have this trapped in fear card, which shows up in his external and or in your external environment, which would be his energy. So there's a sense that he's working on moving into the light, from the darkness to the light. And so this is a crossroads position. It's something that's going to turn up in the near future. So you're both going to feel this energy of feeling like you can't move forward. But here now, he's showing up in your energy, your side. So whereas before you were showing up on his side, he's showing up on your side.
the King of Cups, the King of Love. So, yeah, there's this emotional abundance, control of emotion. It's pure love. It's also a healing energy as well. So he's bringing in this Three of Pentacles. That's that grounding, beginning to see the fruits of your labor. So this card is actually repeated down here in your weekly reading, and it comes in, or your week reading, sorry, and it comes in on Tuesday. So the recent past seems to be coming in on Tuesday, okay? So there's a sense that, you know, something's going to happen, some sort of sign or a victory in the 3D world that has to do with, you know, starting to lay that foundation, I'm thinking. But this card down here talks about guidance, using your internal Buddha to help guide you into the light. You can see on this card here, there's a woman in the corner, and she's turned off to the side. She's got her attention on something else. She's not paying attention to her internal guidance system. So Spirit is saying, listen to that inner voice to guide you. So I'm thinking, you know, this card is kind of taking on that energy since I pulled it. So it seems to me like he's using his internal guidance, his inner knowing, to deal with things in the physical realm, which is going to release himself from this mental prison, okay? And your love for him will do the same. There's a sense that there's going to be a release from this mind trap. Okay, so what you're in the resisting position, we have this message of love, the sense of being closed off or holding too tightly onto your possessions. And then we got the King of Pentacles here. And this is all about, you know, having that ultimate financial abundance in the, being comfortable, living comfortably. But I'm seeing it as more of like, you know, that 3D manifestation of your twin. So you feel that there's a resistance for him to materialize in the 3D. You know, that foundation, you feel that, you know, it's not happening. Whereas he wants to communicate in the 3D, but there seems to be like that sense of being closed off. Okay, so the internal environment. Now, this card could also represent a sudden change. But I think it more has to do with how you guys are viewing each other. There's this, you know, hidden feeling of, am I going to be hurt? Should I trust this person? Should I open myself up to them? So on his side, we have that Seven of Pentacles again that you got there. So that is a sense of waiting for that harvest to come in. So he's sitting here waiting for something to materialize, something that will allow him to finally move forward. Spirit is saying it's on its way, okay? And then you have this tower here. So it's almost like, you know, you're sitting here wanting the tower to come in, but fearing it at the same time. Wondering if it's going to happen, and if it does happen, will it turn out in my favor? You know, there's that sense of fear. You know, will I get what I want? And is it really what I want? So there's a sense that, you know, he's waiting. And because it's taking so long, you know, he's thinking, well, is this worth it? You know, should I just stay where I am instead? You know, it's so much easier for me to stay here because there's no losses involved. But that's what he's breaking free of, that mindset, that fear of moving forward, which is in the crossroads position. You know, should I do it or shouldn't I? I don't know, you know. But the reality is that seed has already been planted in the past. Whether he's conscious of it or not, it is underway. And there's nothing to stop it. You know, as long as you're holding that beautiful, loving, open, grounded energy, balanced energy with your heart chakra open and, you know, continually flowing that love towards him, then that chain will be broken. It's already started. It's inevitable. It's going to happen. So that's confirmed with the external environment. We got that new beginning. Okay, so that's in the works for the both of you. There's that thought in the back of your mind, I want this new beginning. So he's bringing in the Eight of Wands, which is communication. It's a fast movement forward. It's acting on your plans. It's also, you know, triumph, victory, reward for your achievements as well. But it has more to do with communication for my card. And here we are with you. There's that sense that you want this new beginning. It's in the works, but you're sitting there longing and wanting it and waiting for it. Okay, so in the future, this tower will come in. It's going to be sudden, unexpected. But it will provide that, it will be that transformation, that final turn that you've been wanting, that you've been longing for. And it's going to come in very swiftly with the Knight of Swords there. That champion, that rebel without a cause, that person that I don't care. I'm going after, you know, what I want. We're going to make this idea manifest. Okay, and you're bringing in this truth, this freedom of thought, this, you know, cutting away the barriers, this decision. It's like you're both deciding on a goal. You know, something that you wanted in the past, you're both deciding now, okay, yes, let's do it. And it seems to me like it has to do with a conversation that will take place, and it will happen suddenly. So, summary, outcome. We got this feeling of him, okay, the heart chakra, open, unconditional love, no doubt about it, okay? So you're both working towards it. So it's going to give him a sense of being welcomed back into the light, because he was feeling like he was left out in the cold. And then you are bringing in the Knight of Pentacles, that strong, steady movement, directed towards that goal. You are not deterred off your path. It is very calculated. It's happening. This is the way we're going. But it seems to me like he might feel some sort of financial loss as a result. And that might be why he's kind of resisting. There's that sense of being closed off because of something in the material world. Just one moment. I got to adjust myself. Okay, sorry about that. Yeah, so there's that sense of, you know, you're providing that tightrope for which he needs to walk across. And it may result in some type of financial loss for him. I mean, that's a possibility. You know, he wants to start that beginning in the 3D world. but there's a sense that it will result in a loss of some kind. There seems to be a risk that is involved, you know, which is why he's resisting. But here in the past, we got that temptation. That has to do with being attached to something in the material world or placing too much emphasis on it. So the Four of Pentacles talks about not placing your value on material possessions, which is what the King of Pentacles is all about. Even though he's financially independent, he's not placing value on it the way this Four of Pentacles is. He thinks that's all that I am, you know, is what I own in the material world, whereas the King is going, nah, you know, that's not what's important. What's important is love. So it seems to me like he's kind of coming into that knowing, but resisting it, if that makes any sense. All right, so final outcome. We've got the Hangman. So it's surrender, letting go. And you are offering this brand new beginning, this key to the door. You're offering that key to the door that he wants to take. That key that will open the door to the love of his life, his spiritual union, like that, the spiritual union, but also coming together, you know, to create that true love feeling. Then we got this emotional abundance, you know, and that door. So that's what he wants. He wants to walk through that door, and you are holding the key in your hand. So the final outcome is that new perspective, that shift in awareness, which will give him clarity. You know, he'll suddenly know what he wants to do, and then he's going for it. He's moving forward. So that overall energy is him, you know, coming in with his crown chakra open. He's the high priest, victorious, and you are coming in with that thrust forward, that spark, okay, which ignited this whole thing to begin with, okay? Over onto his side. So, actually, we already went through it. So, now I'm going to go through these cards down here at the bottom, the Osho. So, the first card here is possibilities. This is seeing things from a higher perspective. Being open to the possibilities. So, this is a Sunday energy, which I'm going to read to you in a minute. I'll just run through them really quickly. So, then we got Monday. It's this Devil card. It's knowing your true identity and detaching from any conditionings. So the energy for Sunday, Monday, Tuesday is the Three of Pentacles. Like I said, there you might expect this door to be unlocked, which will result in the Eight of Wands coming in on Wednesday. So this could be that communication that's kind of hiding out in the background that will open that door to the new beginning, and ultimately the Tower. So Wednesday, there's that sense that some kind of communication will come in. Then on Thursday, we have this new adventure starting. Moving from the darkness into the light. And that is repeated over here in this theme, where he's moving towards the light, like a child, innocent. But it's the Page of Pentacles, which shows up on his side here as his something that he hopes for, is to move forward, change, as a result of something he's been working on, from the darkness into the light, moving forward. So there's that sense that, you know, that might be taking place on Thursday. Then on Friday, we have this knight coming in, this Knight of Cups. It is a message of love. But in the Osho deck, it also talks about trusting, just letting go of your expectations and trusting that everything, you know, will come towards you. Okay, so that, you know, could be that message of love. These are all messengers. So, or communication, but news coming towards you. These three here. So then on Saturday, we have this Seven of Wands, stress, that card that talks about, you know, never giving up, never surrender, stepping into your power. Remember I was talking about that in your last reading? So, yeah, it's almost like you realize how stressed out that you've been, that you've been juggling too many balls, and you've decided to release yourself from that attachment. You're seeing things from a higher perspective. You're releasing yourself from an attachment. You're allowing your inner guidance to show you the way. You're stepping out onto this new path, or it's not a destination, because the destination is that step that you take. Every step you take in the now is your destination. But it's going to change your perspective. You'll see the world through child's eyes and look towards things as an adventure, and then move forward on that. And trust that everything is going to work out in the end, and ultimately step into this power and step out of stress and live in the now. So, yeah. Okay, so I will read these cards to you, then we're going to read the outcome. All right, I hope this made sense. It's a huge reading to have to organize, and I really enjoy doing it because I love the way it turned out. It keeps repeating your story. If you look at my other readings, they're nothing like yours. Yours always has that repeated theme, and your king keeps showing up. Okay, so BRB. Okay, the first card, possibilities here. So this will be for Sunday. The ego has an overview of all possibilities contained in the landscape below. As he flies freely, naturally, and effortlessly through the sky, he is really in his domain, very grand and self-contained. This card indicates that you are at a point where a world of possibilities is open to you, because you have grown more loving towards yourself, more self-contained. You can work easily with others because you are relaxed and at ease. You can recognize possibilities as they present themselves, sometimes even before others can see them. Because you're in tune with your own nature, you understand that existence is providing you with exactly what you need. Enjoy the flight and celebrate all varied wonders of the landscape spread before you. Conditioning. Unless you drop your personality, you will never be able to find your individuality. Individuality is given by existence. Personality is imposed by society. Personality is social convenience. Society cannot tolerate individuality because individuality will not follow like a sheep. Individuality has the quality of a lion. The lion moves alone. The sheep are always in the crowd, hoping that being in the crowd will feel cozy. Being in the crowd, one feels more protected, secure. If somebody attacks, there is every possibility in a crowd to save yourself. But alone, only the lion moves alone.
And every one of you born, every one of you is born a lion, but the society goes on conditioning you, programming your mind as a sheep. It gives you a personality, a cozy personality. Nice, very convenient, very obedient. Society wants slaves, not people who are absolutely dedicated to freedom. Society wants slaves because all the vested interests want obedience. Okay, so for guidance, the angelic figure with rainbow-colored wings on this card represents the guide that each of us carries within. Like the second figure in the background, we may sometimes be a little reluctant to trust this guide when it comes to us because we are so accustomed to taking our cues from the outside rather than the inside. The truth of your own deepest being is trying to show you where to go right now. And when this card appears, it means you can trust the inner guidance you're being given. It speaks in whispers, and sometimes we can hesitate, not knowing if we have understood rightly. But the indications are clear. In following the inner guide, you will feel more whole, more integrated, as if you are moving outward from the very center of your being. If you go with it, the beam of light will carry you exactly where you need to go. Okay, so the Eight of Wands. The tiny figure moving on the path through this beautiful landscape is not concerned about the goal. He or she knows that the journey is the goal. The pilgrimage itself is the sacred place. Each step on the path is important in itself. When this card appears in a reading, it indicates a time of movement and change. It may be a physical movement from one place to the next, or an inner movement from one way of being to another, and that's that Hangman card. But whatever the case, this card promises that the going will be easy and will bring a sense of adventure and growth. There is no need to struggle or plan too much. The traveling card also reminds us to accept and embrace the new, just as when we travel to another country with a different culture and environment than the one we are accustomed to. This attitude of openness and acceptance invites new friends, experiences into our life. Okay, and the next card is adventure. When we are truly in a spirit of adventure, we are moving just like a child, full of trust, out of the darkness of the forest into the rainbow of light. We go step by step, drawn by our sense of wonder into the unknown. Adventure really has nothing to do with plans and maps, programs and organizations. The page of rainbow represents a quality that can come to us anywhere, at home or in the office, in the wilderness or the city, in a creative project or in our relationship with others. Whenever we move into the new and unknown with the trusting spirit of a child, innocent and open and vulnerable, even the smallest things of life can become the greatest adventure. So it really seems to me like you're moving into something pretty spectacular. Okay, so trust. Now is the moment to be a bungee jumper without the cord. And it is this quality of absolute trust. See, these last three cards here, actually four cards, talk about trust with no reservation or secret safety nets that the night of water demands from us. Let me read that again. Now is the moment to be a bungee jumper without the cord. And it is the quality of absolute trust with no reservations or secret safety nets that the night of water demands from us. There is a tremendous sense of exhilaration if we can take the leap. Whoa, that was kind of funny. Take the leap and they all fell down. Interesting. All right, stay. You made your point. Okay, and when we trust to the level of a quantum leap, We don't make any elaborate plans or preparations. We don't say, okay, I trust that I know what to do now, and I'll settle my things and pack my suitcase and take it with me. No, we just jump with hardly a thought for what happens next. The leap is the thing, the thrill of it, as we free fall through the empty sky. The card gives a hint here, though, about what waits for you on the other side. A soft, welcoming, yummy, pink, rose petal, juicy, come on. So the final card, seven. So number seven, stress. All private goals are neurotic. The essential man comes to know, to feel, I am not separate from the whole, and there is no need to seek and search for any destiny on my own. Things are happening. The world is moving. Call it God. He's doing things. They are happening of our own accord. There is no need for me to make any struggle, any effort. There is no need for me to fight for anything. I can relax and be. The essential man is not a doer. The accidental man is a doer. The accidental man is, of course, then in anxiety, tension, stress, anguish, continuously sitting on a volcano. It can erupt at any moment because he lives in a world of uncertainty and believes as if it is certain. This creates tension in his being. He knows deep down that nothing is certain. Okay, so he got Ride the Wave. Right now, success is easy and effortless. You can be assured that you're entering a time when you can ride the wave of abundance. The tide has turned and you can put your surfing skills to the test. Everything that you know, all of your talents coupled with your hopes and dreams will carry you forward. People and circumstances have come out of the ocean of potential and possibility to take shape in a wave of spectacular activity. Know that you're definitely on the right path. Yeah, baby. Okay, the Magical Map Shifters card you got. Spirit art orchestrates everyone's destiny. When the Magical Map Shifter card arrives, it comes with a mission to make you aware of the people who have come into your life to impact you, your personal growth. Perhaps you meet a soulmate whose presence invites you to be the best you that you can be, or someone who leads you out of difficulty and into a place of safety or success. Pay attention to those individuals who cross your path today and cause you to reflect on your journey. Be awake and aware, and you'll recognize them for the important change agents that they are. Your whole perspective about who you are and why you are here will shift. The Magical Map Shifter always initiates you into a better version of yourself. All right, so I hope this helped, my dear. I love you much. Cheers.